So now what we have to see is that we have the extension. Now we have a very fundamental thing. What we have to see is that the magnetic force, okay, magnetic force depends upon the factors B, Q, V. Okay, it depends upon the magnetic field, charge of the particle, and the velocity of the particle, all the three. Because you know that what I have written, F magnetic is given by Q into V bar cross B bar. Now, if the charge is at rest, assume that the charge is at rest, then I can say that V bar part is zero. If V bar is zero, the magnetic force is also zero. This is a great condition. Why it is like that? It says that the magnetic force does not affect the particles at rest, the charged particles, especially the charged particles at rest. It affects the particles which have some velocity. It affects the, what is it? Magnetic field. Magnetic force. Okay. Magnetic force affects the particles which have some velocity. Now this is a very fundamental point. Now you understand this very, very important. This point is very, very important. So when a charged particle is at rest, it is not affected by the magnetic field. It is affected only by electric field. Please understand this. Very, very important. When it is under motion only, it is affected by the magnetic field. Please note it. So here we generate the condition that we'll write one more point. Only moving charges are affected by the magnetic field. Magnetic force. Only the moving charges are affected by the magnetic force. When magnetic force is maximum. So let's observe this condition. F bar magnetic is given by Q into V bar cross B bar. We know this very well. See, this cross product has to be maximum. Means how the cross product is defined? A bar cross B bar. A bar cross B bar is given by mod A bar into mod B bar into sine of the angle between them times n cap. N cap is the unit vector along A bar cross B bar. That's how it is defined. Now, if sine theta is maximum, then this cross product is maximum. When sine theta is maximum? When theta is 90 degrees, which means that the B bar cross B bar is takes maximum value when B bar is perpendicular to B bar. Very, very important condition. When the cross product of B bar and B bar is maximum, when the magnetic force is maximum, when the velocity of the charged particle is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Suppose this is the direction of the magnetic field, if this is the velocity, both are perpendicular in direction 90 degrees, then you get the maximum magnetic force. I hope I am clear. Once finished, please let me know.
Noted, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Now let us write the condition for the magnitude of the magnetic field. So F magnetic. So I am writing the magnitude. How much is the magnitude of the magnetic field? How to write this? QVB sine theta. That is the magnitude. When theta is equal to 90 degrees, it is given by QVB sine 90. But sine 90 is 1. So you have QVB. So F bar magnetic is given by QVB. Okay. Now, so we can make a note. So when magnetic force will be zero, when theta is equal to 0 degrees or theta is equal to 180 degrees, the magnetic force is zero, right? This is the condition of parallel. This is the condition of anti-parallel. Under these conditions, F bar magnetic will be QVB, either it is sine 0 or QVB, either it is sine 180, both the cases, the answer is 0. Why? This is the parallel condition. Parallel, this is the anti-parallel. So why this is zero? Because sine 0 is 0 and sine 180, they are 0. So suppose the magnetic field direction is like this and the charged particle is moving along the magnetic field, it is unaffected. That is a beauty. the charged particle has to be perpendicular to the magnetic field. Most important, if a charged particle is moving along the direction of the magnetic field or opposite to direction of the magnetic field, it is unaffected by the magnetic force. Most important. So I'll write again. I'll write this point and we'll close today. So this most important point, if the charged particle, so this concludes us, if the charged particle is moving along the direction of magnetic field or opposite to the direction of magnetic field, magnetic field, it suffers no magnetic force. That means unaffected by magnetic field. Unaffected by the magnetic field. It is unaffected by the magnetic field. This is what you have to keep in mind. So when it is moving parallel to the direction of the magnetic field, that is charged particle moving parallel to the direction of magnetic field, or if it is moving opposite to the direction of the magnetic field. So this is the parallel condition, that is theta equal to 0 degrees. This is anti-parallel condition, theta equal to 180 degrees. In both these cases, it is unaffected by the magnetic field. Why? Magnitude of magnetic force is zero. Why? This from the equation QVB sin theta. And you put theta equal to either 0 degrees or 180 degrees. You will get the answer. This is the answer what you are going to get. That is zero. Clear? I hope I am clear. With this we will close. Tomorrow we will see what is a velocity selector, cyclotron, other things what we will see tomorrow. So we will close today. And thank you all. I have another class, it seems. One more. We'll meet tomorrow at again another session. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma.